I would like to announce that I'll be pursuing my dream of trying to play in the NBA. And I'm still leaving the option open that if I don't hear the news that I would like to hear, that I would be attending Mississippi State again next year.
Malik, just kind of take us through the process of what went through all your head going through this decision.
I sat down with my family and talked about it. And, I mean, we think, that we'll have a really good chance of making my dreams come true. And with the development that Coach Howland helped me with throughout the season as becoming a point guard, I think it really helped me.
Malik, what's the moment like, as you said, it's been your dream to always, you know, play at the next level. What's it like to be that much closer to it, I guess?
It's exciting. It's very exciting. You know, it's, like you said, it's right here. So I just have to put in all the time and hard work to, you know, make the dreams happen.
What's next, do you think? Are you staying on campus or are you going somewhere? What's next for you?
We're still talking about that right now. So, nothing is in concrete with that.
Is there a particular spot in the draft that you're weighing the options one way or the other?
No, not really. I mean, just, hoping, we can get something good in the first round and, see where the options from there.
Ben, what was your kind of advice from Lee? You've obviously dealt with players like him before. What did you kind of tell him?
Well, this was the plan from when the first day I met Malik recruiting him. We expected that he would put his name into the draft and explore this opportunity this year. So this is not anything that was unexpected, number one. Number two, my advice moving forward is he's got to really hit the ground running now in terms of his workouts, his conditioning. And so in my opinion, it's better for him to, since his classes are online, and he did a great job last summer and in the fall, that he is really ahead of schedule academically, and he can still do his work and maintain his eligibility if he wants the option to come back at the end of this process. And so I think it's better for him to leave and to go to a situation where they're gonna have to pay for a workout situation to get ready and prepare for the draft. That means working out twice a day, the component of nutrition, the component of lifting. At this point now, we only get to work with our players 2 hours a week. He needs 4 hours a day to fulfill the opportunity to do his very best. And so I'm excited for him because I think it's going to be a great challenge. And I think he'll really do well. I think he's going to compete well. And I think the things that he's learned this year, making the jump from high school to college, is going to really serve him well. And, I'm excited for him. I think it's going to be a great opportunity. And now, the new rules are that, so you guys have understanding, he can work out for every NBA team, and the NBA team can pay for that. So you can work out for 30 teams in the NBA. It's a 48-hour deadline to be on those trips, which obviously they all know. And then he also has a thing in Chicago, which is the 15th. I think it's the 12th through the 15th. So 10 days after Chicago, which is the combine, where 70 players are invited to go, he'll have 10 days. He'll have May 25th to make the decision to leave his name in or still coming back out. Because my understanding of meeting with Horatio and Luke this morning, they are not going to hire an agent, which is the key factor in keeping, their receipts for everything and showing, everything that they've done financially, to leaving that option open. And I've had players that have gone through it and come back, and players have gone through it and gone forward. So, it happens both ways. And this is a lifelong dream for him to realize the opportunity to play in the NBA, and we're excited for him.
Coach, he mentioned development under your direction. Where do you feel like he's made the most gains this year at Mississippi State?
Well, I think he's really improved as a defensive player, number one. And when you get to that level of the NBA, it's different than the college game, and it's even more one-on-one because everybody can shoot. The floor gets stretched so much more that there's a level of intensity and an understanding of a sense of urgency that you have to have on every possession. I love the NBA. The Golden State, where we were in the middle of the NCAA tournament the other night, and I'm watching Golden State San Antonio because that's such an outstanding game. I had to, like, you know, flip back and forth because I was really, you talk about a high level game. That was like a, you know, a final in the NBA the other night.